We, the class of 2012, have assembled here to remember our past and to look forward to our future. Tonight, we celebrate the culmination of 14 years of school. We celebrate this accomplishment together as one. As graduates of Bishop Macdonell Catholic High School. Although we are at the end of one chapter, we are also beginning another. In this chapter, we will stay in touch with some, and others we may never see again, but we will cherish our memories. It is only now we truly begin to comprehend how lucky we are to be able to share this time together. On behalf of the class, I would like to introduce our welcome today. His Excellency Bishop Crosby, Reverend Father Newton, our Director, Mr. Bell, Board of Administration, our Principal, Ms. Conway, and Vice Principals, Mr. Bell, OJ, and Mr. Olson, the faculty, and our friends and family to join us as the most memorable occasion. You may have noticed that the graduates proceeded in and carried a single rose. The rose symbolizes one of our own, Isabel, whose love of life, family, and friends will be with us always. It was Isabel and her strong faith that taught us the most important lesson of life. From Matthew chapter 9, verses 19 and 20. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely, I am with you always, to the very end of the age. I know that you will be forever in our hearts. As our journey continues, may our faith and our spirit guide into all of our future endeavors.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Thessalonians. But we must always give thanks to God for you, brothers and sisters, beloved by the Lord, because God chose you as the first fruits for salvation through sanctification by the Spirit and through believing in the truth. For this purpose he called you through our proclamation of the good news, so that you may obtain the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. So then, brothers and sisters, stand firm and hold fast to the traditions that you were taught by us, either by word of mouth or by our letter. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our loved us and through grace gave us eternal comfort and good hope. Comfort your hearts and strengthen them in every good work and word. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Accompanied by Joe Prairie from the class of 1991.
Thank you. Where do you wish to be? If you are even remotely uncertain about the future as I am, I'm sure it is difficult to picture yourself. Are you so certain that you can recognize this individual? Your Excellency, Bishop Crosby, Reverend Father Newman, Religious Sisters, our Director, Ms. Macdonell, Board Administration, Trustees, our Principal, Ms. Conway, Vice Principals, Mr. Della Croce and Mr. Olson, faculty, honored guests, friends, and graduates. A very short 4 years ago, many of us lived in a situation that paralyzed our uncertainty today. We were about to embark on a new adventure, full of promise and excitement. Until that point, high school had been but a distant destination. Upon arriving at the school, it had become quite a way. In our first year, a great many of us were concerned with forming friendships and searching for our true character. It was not an easy ordeal, to say the least. We were torn by the death of our dear classmate and friend, Isabel Wall. The poem Remember Me is a fitting tribute to her life. To the living, I am gone. To the sorrowful, I will never return. To the angry, I was cheated. But to the happy, I am at peace. And to the faithful, I have never left. I cannot be seen, but I can remember. So as you stand upon the shore, gazing at a beautiful sea, remember me. As you look in awe at a mighty forest and its grand majesty, remember me. As you look upon a flower and admire its simplicity, remember me. Remember me in your heart, your thoughts, and your memories of the times you loved, the times you cried, the times you fought, the times you laughed. For if you always think of me, I will have never gone. I believe I speak first of all in saying your passing is instilled within our hearts, a firm belief that every sunrise brings about a vast opportunity to make the best of each day. We are made thankful for all our blessings. We do not know when we will be called home. As we are here 4 years later, ready to accept our diplomas, our success over the challenges of high school, I ask you one final request. Never lose faith in your ability to change the world. Be confident as you approach each day. Be yourself. Learn from Norman Rice's quotation. Dare to reach every hand into the darkness to pull another hand into the light. After all, it is our duty as human beings to better the course of mankind. And I know we all have something special and unique to unveil to the world that is sometimes called ugly. Being Celtic, I cannot refrain from addressing our virtues, wisdom, honor, and courage. I will not stand here and give you the idea that changing the world is easy. Remember, nothing will happen is ever easy. In order to make change a reality, we must have courage to be different in the face of injustice. We must have honor and stand by our true personality when it is tested. And we must have the wisdom to enrich the hearts, minds, and lives of all those around us. If you struggle to find inspiration, look around you. Our parents, teachers, priests, friends, and families have all had their fair share of experience in building our world. On behalf of the class of 2012, we thank you. Classmates, the next step is yours to take. Yours to make a difference. Lord Baden Powell humbly phrased my personal motto when he said, try to leave this world a little better than you found it. When it is your time, be content in the knowledge that you have. And, in the words of St. Paul, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, and I have kept the faith. Congratulations, fellow graduates. Best of luck in all future endeavors, and God bless.
On behalf of the graduating class of 2012, I would like to extend our sincere thanks to you, the Excerpts,
Bishop Crosby, for celebrating this momentous occasion with us this evening. We appreciate your words of wisdom that have helped inspire us to be rooted in our faith as we continue our journey. Thank you. Thank you to the clergy, to the Sisters of Loretto, and especially to you, Father Newman, who planted the seeds of our faith and encouraged us to lead a Christ-centered life. As well, I would like to thank our director, Mr. Drone, board administration, trustees for the support and encouragement throughout our years of Catholic education. Thank you to our leaders, Ms. Conley, Mr. Del Croce, Mr. Olson, and the entire faculty of Bishop Macdonell, who have both shaped and guided us into who we are today and who we will become. Last but certainly not least, we, the graduates of 2012, would like to extend a sincere thank you to our parents, guardians, and family who nurtured us from the beginning. And I would also like to extend a personal thank you to Mrs. Morrison, wherever she is, for helping me and the